Here's how the United Nations described Agenda 21 in one of its own publications in 1993 in an article entitled Agenda 21, the Earth Summit Strategy to Save Our Planet. It said, quote, Agenda 21 proposes an array of actions which are intended to be implemented by every person on Earth. It calls for specific changes in the activities of all people. Effective execution of Agenda 21 will require a profound reorientation of all humans, unlike anything the world has ever experienced. End quote. Have you ever heard a more powerful manifesto issued for the purpose of government? And yet, when you and I point out these things and protest against it, we are attacked as fringe radicals. Well, here is the exact course that brought Agenda 21 to America and into your local community. At the top of the infrastructure, pushing sustainable development in the United Nations is the United Nations Environmental Program, or the UNEP. But the UNEP doesn't operate on its own. It's influenced by thousands of non-governmental organizations, NGOs. These are private groups who seek to implement a special political agenda. Through the UN infrastructure, particularly through the UNEP, they have incredible power. And I should point out that a true NGO group isn't something that just pops up somewhere and somebody says, I'm an NGO. These groups are officially sanctioned and certified by the United Nations to participate in these international meetings and these efforts. They have a document that they have to fill out, an application. It's about that thick. And they pledge to implement United Nations policies.